today, here we find ourselves in the studio of someone very well known to people who love soul music in the UK and worldwide. He's brought us many, many tunes which are just really memorable. Things like There's Nothing Like This and other ones which I just can't quite remember, but I'm sure he's going to remind us in a brief moment. We're talking about the man Omar. Into your hallowed premises.
Thank you very much.
Thanks a lot. What have you been up to? We've not heard from you for about the last 5 years. Talk to us. What's been going
on? It's 7 years since the last album.
7 years?
Yeah. I became a daddy. Twin girls. They're almost six now.
Oh, congratulations.
Thank you very much. I was touring, doing a lot of gigs worldwide. Also writing the music for this album. I started acting about 4 years ago. Mm. Currently my own one-man play. So pretty busy, all in all. Moved down to Brighton as well.
I can feel it's like walking in sunshine. This is it, something real. Let's get on, don't waste time.
I mean, what inspired you for the latest album, yeah, The Man? What inspired you for that?
Typical things, music that inspires me is, you know, reggae, soul, Latin, jazz, funk. Mm. I was classically trained, so a lot of, string arrangements, orchestral arrangements and things. I like to try and infuse into the music as well. Nice. And just like on my travels, you know, I'm just bumping into people and seeing what kind of music they're doing as well. Mm-hmm. And also I think having kids has kind of like spurred me on even more so. I mean, I was kind of not anxious, but sort of wondering how it was going to be once I had children, you know, right. Because I wonder if that would take up a major portion of my life. Am I going to like forget about the music or what? But if anything, it spurred me on to make more music. You know what I mean? They kind of give you a purpose. I wouldn't change it for the world, basically.
Have you found the lyrical content of your songs changing since you've had children?
I've written one song with them in mind, which was called Ordinary Day, which is the last song on the album.
Yeah, I remember.
And I purposely, you know, wrote this song about them because I thought, you know, this is such a great feeling to have kids. But then when we were shooting the video for The Man, the director, Robin Brunson.
Is that the one which was filmed down in Brighton Beach?
Down in Brighton, okay, Brighton Beach.
Ooh, my baby has this thing, she does and she only, yeah.
He suggested that we film it in Brighton. I was thinking, why film it in Brighton? That's where we live, that's where the family lives,
right
in Hove to be precise. Right. I could get the girls involved in the first verse because I'm kind of singing about, you know, something changed me. I used to be a certain way, but then something changed me, which would be having kids. Mm. And in the second verse, I'm actually singing about the missus. Mm. But I hadn't actually written the song with them in mind, you know. Right. I was just going with the vibe of the melody. Because every time I write songs, I just go with the melody of the song. So quite a simple thing. But then it just kind of like more and more came to light as we're shooting the video. Mm. Maybe this is who I'm singing about, you know.
Right.
And that's kind of how I work. I kind of work backwards. You know, I kind of go with the vibe.
So it's the vibe and the music first, and then the lyrics.
Always
afterwards.
Lyrics afterwards. Okay. I've never written lyrics first and then.
That intrigues me, because looking at something like what most people would see is probably your biggest and most well known hit. There's Nothing Like This. Mm. Did you do the lyrics first for that, or was was that the vibe first?
Yeah, it was the vibe.
There's nothing like this. There's nothing.
I mean, I started out with the music because I've been listening to a song called Heaven Must Be Like This by the Ohio Players.
Yeah.
And at the time, you know, it was 89 probably when I started writing it. And at the time, I don't know if you remember, back in the day, it was all acid house.
Right.
Hip hop was kind of like just starting out. So everything was about the sequences and the samplers. A lot of, synthetic music. Mm. And I'd, been brought up playing in orchestras and brass bands and percussion ensembles and basically playing with live musicians.
Right.
So at the time, I just wanted to recreate something that I was hearing.
Right.
You know, there was a movement of us people doing that at that time. There was myself, Brand New Heavies, Young Disciples, Incognito, Galliano, all kind of trying to do this retro style. So that's what I was, that's all I was trying to recreate, you know. So anyway, I heard this song and I wanted to do something like that.
Right.
So you can hear the influence from that song in my tune. But I did all the music I started probably about 11 o'clock in the morning, finished about 5 o'clock, had a break. Went and had myself a cup of tea. We'll call it a cup of tea. Exactly. And then I came back and wrote the lyrics. So it's pretty much written in a day.
And that's really interesting because the testament of the strength of that song, both the melody and lyrics, is that it's still a classic so many years later. So people still hear it and it still sounds fresh today. Even so, I've got to add that anybody who decides to actually listen to your new CD and actually goes out and buys it will hear you've actually done another version of that.
I kind of wanted to do like a 20th anniversary of the song, which would have been 2010, but it took me, as everything does, it takes me a while to kind of like work out what I'm doing.
Okay.
And it didn't dawn on me till 2012 how I was supposed to redo the song. Because
right.
I'd started out trying to just replay that like over the original master tracks, but that wasn't really cutting it. So then I decided to try it in a different, try to beat in a different way and try to chords in a different way. But it took me a while to get there. And as luck would have it, I think it was like the week before, Pino Palladino called me and said, "Man, I'm in town. Let's do some music together." I'm like, "Okay, what can we do?" And then everything just worked out. It was perfect. He came the next day after I just worked out how to do the song.
Right.
And put his beautiful stamp on it, and that just like lifted everything else up, and then I could just work on the arrangements and
what about collaborations on the man? I mean, because in the past you've worked with so many different people, Stevie Wonder to name just one of them.
Don't you worry about a thing. Yeah. Don't you worry about a thing, mama.
He always throws that name in when it comes to you, and I can understand why you'd be proud to say you've worked with him. And he's also proud, I've read, to say he's worked with you, which is fantastic, as far as I'm concerned, being a UK guy myself. So, I mean, who's collaborating on this latest? You mentioned, was it
Palladino? Well, it's Pino before. Palladino. Also, Stuart Zender, who's a friend of mine from back in the day. He used to play bass for Jamiroquai. He's playing on Ordinary Day. Also Caron Wheeler.
Yeah.
Me and Caron go back. She's actually sang backing vocals on my second single, You and Me.
Was it You and Me? I was trying to remember. Was it Postman?
Forget about that.
Yeah, I know you don't like it. I know. Omar brought a single out which he's not proud of. And I feel that I should tell you about it. But yeah, was it called Postman?
Cut.
Was it called Postman?
Mr. Postman.
Mr. Postman. Mm. If you could find it, please send me a copy. That's all I'm going to say.
I'm going to kill you after this.
Okay, right.
Really stick rigid in one space. Music is there to enjoy. You know, I did the dance tunes with Zed Bias, Dancing and Special. And that was another thing as well. I'm in Hong Kong and they asked me to do Special and I didn't even bring the baggage track for that. But they're like, "Yeah, man, that's the one we want to hear." Or if they want to hear Dancing or they want to hear It So. You know what I mean? So those ones are slightly different, slightly out of the box from what I'm known for normally doing, you know? Like I said, I'm here to open up people's imaginations maybe a little bit, just to see there's a little, there's
variation
different ways you can hear music, and music can be done, rather than sticking to this playlisted, regimented, way that maybe certain radio stations might play them, or do you know what I mean?
I understand.
It's not about that, it's about expressing yourself.
Yeah. Oh. I've been sitting going crazy.
So now with, you know, the release of The Man, what date's it coming out? Enough time for you to
24th of June.
The 24th of June, mm-hmm. Going to be released. What's next for you?
Well, getting out on the road, basically. Okay. It seems there's
touring. Have you got dates already set up?
There's lots of dates coming in. There's not an actual tour as such.
Yeah, not a roster set up at the moment.
No, there's just lots of different. I mean, I just came back from Italy. I've got to go to France after this.
Right.
They're talking about Cambodia and Jakarta again. In August, and also the US plus Japan. So
this is fantastic.
It's just an ongoing thing.
So what I would say is, I'm trying to work out the best way that people can get into to know what you're up to on a day-to-day basis. Give us, there must be a way they can check
Facebook,
out website Facebook,
Facebook. Official
give us some details on that, because people are here thinking, I want to know more.
Official Omar UK is my Facebook page, so mm-hmm. You can go there and like that. Also at Omar Lye-Fook MBE, so it's Lye-F of Freddie OOK.
Okay.
And I'm always updating
those. Okay, and you've got your own website there as well?
Website is omarmusic.co.uk.
Okay, so people can find out where you're at and what you're up to and where
Absolutely.
You're touring and stuff on that, yeah?
Yeah.
Well, listen, I wish you all the best for this latest CD. I think it's actually one of your best for ages.
Thank you.
It's varied, the quality of the production's there, and I think your voice has matured fantastically as well, so it's really, you know, it's a pleasure.
Thank you
very much. And thanks very much for your time.
My pleasure.
We'll catch you another time. Keep smiling, man.
That's fine.
All right. Easy.